Good morning, YouTube. Welcome once again to another video by The Self-Sufficient Life. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to turn this big bucket into a grow tower. This is going to be the next video in the Maximizing Garden Space series. Due to popular request, many have asked me to show them how I turned this into a grow tower. And that's what we're going to be focusing on today. Now, you're going to notice that I get pretty detailed on many things here and laying it out and measuring and stuff. That's due primarily to the fact that I spent many years working as a carpenter, and I tend to get pretty anal about these things. Before we get started, I suppose I should show you all at once what tools we're going to need. First of all, get you a pencil to be able to mark this. Next, you're going to need a tape measure. I'm actually using a seamstress tape measure because this is not flat, it's round, and it needs to be good and flexible. The next, you're going to need a drill. You're going to need a 3-foot level, and if possible, a 6-inch level. You're going to need a jigsaw to be able to cut the holes. Now, in lieu of a 6-inch level, I'm going to be using a speed square. You're also going to be needing a hot air gun, which I don't have out here.
What is this gun called? This tool called is called a heat gun or a hot air gun. But this is what it looks like. And this one was not a very expensive one. You can pick them up inexpensive. You can also get them very expensive. But I don't know that, unless you're working on professional stuff and going to be doing a whole lot of stuff, really not worth getting a really expensive one, maybe. Don't know. Anyway. Okay, friends, first thing you're going to do is you're going to pick a point, any point, anywhere you want. We're starting fresh here. You're going to take your 3-foot level, put it down there on the bottom. Oops, cut it upside down. You're going to mark off, get it level, or not level, but rather plumb, and mark. And that's going to be your center line. Next thing you're going to do is to determine the outside lines. Now, my tape measure has both standard and metric. I'm going to be using centimeters because I like the smaller increments. And also the millimeters are marked on here too. And for things like this, I find these to be a little bit more exact. Like I said, I'm pretty anal. Now, I have decided to make this first hole 10 centimeters. So you want to go 5 centimeters out from the center line on one side and mark it. Come 5 centimeters out on the other line and mark it. Then you're going to take your level again. You're going to put it on that line and move the bottom back and forth until you get the bubble showing plumb, and then mark it. And then you're going to do the same thing on the other side over here. Now that's going to give you your side-to-side measurements. Next thing you want to do is decide how deep you want your first hole. Now I have chosen to go, it's approximately 6 inches deep, and centimeters is right at 15. Okay. Take your level and put it on top. Instead of trying to eyeball even with the top here, put it up here and put your the end of your tape measure there, and then place it there and mark where you want your first one. Now I am going a little bit deeper here because I'm going to be planting in the top as well. And what I'm thinking of is maybe some carrots. But at any rate, one of the things you've got to think about when you're determining your spacing on all of this is your root system. One problem that growing in containers has is that it tends to get root bound. And your root system is very important for a good healthy plant. And when you've got a root bound pot, your plant does not grow and produce as well. So I am leaving 6 inches here. I figure that is good enough to be able to plant carrots or other plants right there. It gives plenty of room to be able to grow down and to get a good root system. Next thing you're going to do is you've got the marks right here. You're going to take your speed square. Now, if you've got a 6-inch level, you can do that with this. You can just put the level up there and hold it there until it gets level, and then mark across. Now, if you're using a speed square, you don't know how to use it, you take this edge right here and line it up with one of these outside lines. Keep it lined up, and then just draw a line straight across. Next, you want to take your drill. Now you got to make sure that your drill bit is big enough so that your saw blade is going to fit into it. And then where the lines intersect on either side, just drill a hole into it so that you can cut from here all the way across. Now, what we'll do now is I will go ahead and cut this for you. So now we have the beginnings of our first hole that we're going to make. But there's one other thing that you need to do before you start with this. With this center line, you want to take your tape measure and go all the way around and measure and find out how far it is between here, all the way around, back to the same point. This is going to give you the measurements that you need to be able to calculate how many holes you can get, because you're going to need to calculate the holes plus the spacing in between. And to do the math on it, you're going to need to know the entire circumference from this point, not from up here, not from down here, because you see this thing is angled. And up here, it is 203 centimeters. Down here, it is 216 centimeters. It gets bigger as you go along. So, unless you really want to, it's really not necessary to do it for each level of the holes. Because what you may want to do, which is what I'm going to do, is that once I determine the level for each one of my holes, I'm just going to come in directly in between and offset my holes, and I'm not going to worry about measuring around for each one, only measuring down to determine my level. We'll move on to the next step here now. Alright, my friends, I've had a few difficulties, and I've had to switch to this container. The green container turned out to be too thick, and was having a lot of difficulties with it. I'm going to have to enlist some aid and have help to work on it. So I switched over to this one. Well, I began having difficulties with this one. This one turns out to be way too thin. And it's, as you can see, if you can see right in there, it's starting to split a little bit. So it's too thin. So I had to work on it a bit to kind of develop the technique a little bit better so I could show you. But here's what I've done. I have taken this, which is a pole that is cut in half lengthwise so that it's rounded to be able to use to pull it out. Now what I'm going to do is I want to get the top part first and get it pushed in. So we're going to get it heated up. And always keep your gun moving so that you can evenly distribute the heat. Got it up a little bit. Now what I'm doing now, I'm holding it back, trying to get underneath. I'm going to go up the sides on each side. While that's cooling, I am trying to bring it up, the indentation up a little bit, so that that gives it just that little bit much more room for the plants to be able to have room to grow in. Let's see how well that's doing. That's cooling off better. Now I'm going to take it, turn it around. Now what I'm going to do is this time I'm going to put it up a little bit of an angle and try to get it directly in the center. Now I'm going to bring in an arc, and I'm going to try to avoid, because it's so thin and splits, I'm going to try to avoid overheating the top part and just kind of go in an arc underneath. See, it's beginning to as it begins to melt, the sides will stretch some and the bottom will bend. I'm holding it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this 2x3 and stick in there to hold it. Yeah, you see right there. But the 2x3 will hold it until it cools off to, and it'll keep the shape with the hole. Now, I had mentioned on one of my other videos that you would want to kind of make the cut in an arc. Well, my primary experience had been with items with pipes that were much smaller diameter, and I believe that the arc in a small diameter would be better. But with something like this, I do believe that making a straight cut would be better. Well, guys, I hope it's okay. And here's the finished product. Got them all the way around there. Only got three levels. There is room, I guess I could put one more level down there,
but I'm planning on putting about 2 inches of gravel on the bottom to facilitate the drainage, water drainage out of it. I've got holes drilled all throughout the bottom. Well, guys, I hope this helped everybody. You guys have a good day.